You're looking live at the Crew Dragon spacecraft and Falcon 9 rocket set to launch four astronauts to the International Space Station in just a few hours. Today, a crew of two Americans, one European, and one Japanese astronaut will set off on a six-month science mission to the world's only orbiting laboratory. Welcome to NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida. I'm Marie Lewis with NASA Communications.
And I'm Kate Tice, Senior Certification Engineer at SpaceX. Joining us today is NASA astronaut Tracy Caldwell Dyson. Welcome, Tracy.
Thank you, Kate. Thank you, Marie. It's sure a pleasure to be here. You know, it's a busy month for human spaceflight with traffic to and from the International Space Station, and today's launch of Crew-2 is a very exciting part of that, and I'm just so pumped that I get to be right here.
And Tracy, we were talking earlier about when the last time was you were in Florida for a launch.
That was in 2011 for STS-135. I had just returned from my space station mission, and they needed some help in the C-squared group, the Cape Crusader, and so I came here to support.
Well, we are so happy to have you back for this new era of human spaceflight. A quick note for you all, we have each been vaccinated against COVID-19, and so that's why you see us sitting here together without masks on. We want to keep everyone safe and healthy.
At 5:49 this morning Eastern Time, NASA astronauts Shane Kimbrough, Megan MacArthur, European Space Agency astronaut Thomas Pesquet, and Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency astronaut Aki Hoshide will lift off from Launch Complex 39A, which you see right there, at NASA's Kennedy Space Center as part of the agency's Commercial Crew program. This crew will relieve the four Crew-1 astronauts who have been living and working on station since November. This will be the first time that SpaceX reuses both a first stage and a Crew Dragon capsule. This booster supported the Crew-1 mission, and the capsule, Dragon Endeavour, flew astronauts Bob Behnken and Doug Hurley to the space station in last year's history-making Demo 2 test flight.